My name is Alissa Pena. I'm 26 years old. I am 5'3", and I weigh 282 right now. Getting pregnant was a struggle. We tried actively to get pregnant for about a year straight. When I couldn't get pregnant, William moved out, and I found out I was pregnant like 3 weeks later.
Some people would say, you know, oh, they're having a kid now, you know, they should get back together. But it's not that easy. I live about a block away. It's been 6 months since I moved out. One of the ingredients in our arguments, why we'd always get into fights, was her health. She never took care of herself. It really tears me up. It really does. It breaks my heart because I care about her. Obesity is a real killer, especially when you're diabetic.
I was diagnosed with diabetes when I was 17. It's hereditary in my family. Because I'm pregnant, I'm on an insulin regimen. Before I found out that I was pregnant, I was on insulin and like 3 or 4 other pills for the control of my sugar. With this pregnancy, I've been dealing with the diabetes and also a very serious eye disease. It was towards the end of my second trimester when I started to develop blurry spots in the middle of my eye. I thought it was makeup that, you know, that I didn't wash out of my eye. I went to the emergency room that night, and that's when they diagnosed it as the diabetic retinopathy.
Good morning, Ms. Pena.
Good morning.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good to see you. Let's take a look, right? Comfortable there?
Dr. Wyckoff told me that it was so far advanced that if I would have waited like maybe another 2 or 3 days, I would have gone blind.
Sit back. When Alissa first came in, this is the back of her right eye. She had a lot of bleeding in the back of her eye, and you can see these red spots here that are blood overlying the front of her retina. And when you put that in the context of pregnancy, all the issues simply become magnified.
I'm going in to get laser treatments on my eye. It's very painful.
Feel that?
Mm-hmm.
We've put in 173 spots. I'd love to get to 500 today.
When she had her eye problem, that scared the hell out of me. I'm thinking, you know, she's about to give birth to my boy, and what if she's blind? She doesn't deserve that. But I want her to see my child.
Ooh.
Hey.
Hello.
Give me a hug. We are at Alyssa's doctor to do her ultrasound.
Bebe can give me a hug too.
I've taken off work, so I'm here.
I get to see my son in the ultrasound.
Hi, Ms. Pena.
Hi.
You
want
to come back?
Growing up, I was heavy. I've been heavy since I was like 6 or maybe 8.
284.1 today, and the last time it was 282.2.
Right now, this is the heaviest that I've been ever.
Good afternoon.
Hello.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Good.
Hi, Alissa. How are things?
Good, good.
How's the baby treating you?
Dr. J is a wonderful doctor, a high-risk pregnancy doctor. He just makes me feel very, very comfortable.
How's the baby moving?
Good. This morning, he woke me up at 5 o'clock.
Okay. The head is down. That is good news.
Okay.
This is baby's hair.
So my son has hair already.
Yes. Lots of it. We're dealing with a weight of 4 pounds, 2 ounces.
And everything's looking good?
Everything so far is looking very, very good.
Okay.
This is the baby's heartbeat.
Hearing his heartbeat, that's like the most amazing sound to me. I'm excited. I kind of don't want it to end, but then some days I do. I want the baby to come out already.
When was the last time you had seen the baby, William?
I can't remember. I think it was the first 2 months.
So it has been a while, huh?
Yeah, I haven't seen him fully developed.
I'm gonna try to take a shot of the baby's face for the two of you. Look at that.
Ah, see his face, oh my God.
A little bit blurry.
Seeing my son in the ultrasound makes me feel like, oh my God, there's a little person inside of her.
Looks like he's smiling. Look at that.
Oh my God.
He's mine and Alyssa's.
I see his nose, I see his eyes.
He's something I can say, it's a miniature me, you know, and he's my son.
Hi, Alissa.
Hi.
You made it.
Yes.
Alissa has been scheduled for an induction of labor. Lots and lots and lots of pressure. Over the next 2 to 3 days, we are hoping to achieve a vaginal delivery. We might give you something taken by mouth, and that will cause both contractions, but also softening on your cervix.
Okay.
Right now, or her blood work, liver function, renal function, and hematologic function is normal. Her blood pressures have been increasing.
Medication is going to
the longer we wait, in theory, the higher those risks are. And,
if you need me for anything tonight, just give me a call.
All right. Okay.
This is day 2. She's being induced, so who knows how long baby will take.
William's been supportive and he's been here. He's trying not to cause any stress or anything like that.
I know it sucks that we don't live together and we're having issues, but I'm not letting these issues come between me and her and what my duties are. I mean, I have to be here. You know, this is my son, too.
And your toes turn to sausages.
Right there, this little sausage.
Knock, knock. Hi, Alissa.
Hello.
How are you doing today?
Good.
We're gonna check on your cervix. All right.
Let's try to relax, I know it's hard.
Let's see. It looks like her cervix is minimally changed, which is unfortunately not what we expected.
I am feeling very frustrated with the whole situation.
I was expecting him to say it's a go, but Alyssa's not dilating.
It doesn't seem that we're heading anywhere with the induction. I think we probably have to decide to do a cesarean section. So we have to do what we have to do. That's the way I see it.
This surgery was not the plan, but nothing has really happened, so I'm just a little bit nervous.
How are you doing, Alissa?
Good.
It's coming. Happy birthday!
Happy.
Yeah.
Happy.
Alissa, turn to your right. You're gonna see your baby. Okay. Can she see him real quick? Mama.
You want some,
Yes.
Sure.
Big boy.
It's been a long process. It wasn't easy. After what I've seen, I really can't miss out on my son. From here on, it's gonna be Junior's time.
I'm not gonna just get back with him for the baby. I want it to be for all of us.